The Mark Hubbard Show. It's the Mark Hubbard Show.
All right. Good afternoon and welcome to the Mark Hubbard Show. I am Uncle Mark. I am the host because it is the Mark Hubbard Show. But you know how we do it here on the Mark Hubbard Show. We always like to make sure that we are able to service those that are less fortunate in their mindset. And with that being said, I bring on the rest of the team. We have mindset, low mindset, Brother Reg. Low mindset DJ Mike Caliber and just like low that. Mindset Lady D.
Something wrong with you.
Something wrong with me. Gotcha.
The better question is, did he write that down? I feel like he was preparing that.
I don't really have to write that.
I think they came straight off the dome.
You think so? Bam, right off of it. Bam, just came right. I didn't write that one down. Thank you. But anyways, I was.
Something wrong.
Was you farted?
I think my dog did.
Make that look like, oh, it's got me.
Yeah, you know that fart look, right? That's that fart look. That smell. That yeah, that's that. What's that smell?
He waited till the show came on to do it too.
And listen, you know, Kobe has his moment. He has his moment. He's either gonna use the washroom when the show come on, or he gonna let me have it. But this is the bad thing about it, because you know, it's not like everybody on this show. Everybody, if you hear me, you fart, right? So it don't always smell good either, right? It's not like it smells like roses. But this is the thing that gets me about my dog, right?
I'm talking about this.
Hold on. I'm gonna bring it up. Mike brought it up. Hold on.
I didn't keep it going.
Right, you know, we'll keep it going. Let me tell you what makes me mad about my dog. He gets offended when I pass gas. He's like, gets up, look at me, and walk out the room like I'm mad, like I did wrong. But then it's okay for him to fart, and he can just say,
So just so you know, there are things that we do that's part of human nature that we don't necessarily
talk about. But that's a part of human nature. We don't need to talk about it.
We don't want to talk about farting.
I didn't bring it up. Mike brought it up. He said, you got that stink. Somebody farted. Look, so I just decided to talk about it. Why is it that y'all don't want to talk about things that are part of human nature?
But I didn't keep it going, though.
You didn't have to keep it going. That's not your job. Your job is to bring topics up. I'm going to keep it going. We all have our role.
All right. So this is the Mark Hubbard Show.
It is. And Mark Hubbard was talking about farting.
That wasn't the topic for today, was it, Reggie?
Reg is all the way off. You took him off his square.
That's right. Unmentionable.
Unmentionable. You don't talk about it. I mean, it's not a topic, especially for a radio show on where everyone across the world can see it. I mean,
everybody across the world has farted before, so what's the problem? I don't get it. You offended?
We don't make it news.
Man, y'all letting Mark win this argument. That's the
I promise you. We talking about.
He winning the argument. It's not fun when he wins the argument.
Now, I don't know if he's winning the argument or making. Yeah.
No, I'm never going to make that, Reggie. Now, keep going. Now you can move on. Don't try it, sir. We all fart. Now, move on.
And then that's the word to use too, right? I mean, pass gas, flatulence. I mean, there are other words.
We'll be polite. I'm sorry, audience. We've all passed gas before.
Oh my goodness.
This is the Mark Hubbard Show. We are here every Friday, 2 p.m. until about.
And it really depends upon what you eat. Woo, Jesus.
Right here on Facebook Live and YouTube. And the comments and opinions of Mark Hubbard are the comments and opinions of Mark Hubbard.
on the Mark Hubbard Show. Let's make sure you put that
on the Mark Hubbard Show. So
there you go.
Anyway.
Okay. So he can have his comments and opinion. So let's move on, Reggie.
We always have a great set of music. We have a great guest that's joining us.
It can be loud, silent, or really soft. You can't even hear sometimes.
You tell me to move on, but you keep talking, right?
Right. Talking about farting. And you know what? I said I was going to be good today, but Mike brought it up. He said fart.
I'm 5 years old. Yeah. Just like a little kid. Keep that conversation going. So, we have a great set of music coming up. We have a great guest that's joining us today.
He farts too.
Shannon Lowe is in the backstage. We're going to bring Shannon to the stage. Shannon Lowe is a singer, songwriter, producer, all of the above. We're glad to have him joining us.
Shannon has his kids and grandkids. He know about farting.
Thank you for joining us today. Welcome to the
Mark Hubbard Show. Oh, my goodness.
Shannon, you got grandkids and 6 kids. You know all about farting. Oh, my God. Don't you?
I guess I came in on the right day. Mark should have called everybody low mindset. I'm low, L-O-W-E.
That's it. You fit right in. You fit in. Your name fits right in. Low mindset.
No help him out with how he came up with
that. Thank you. See? You fit right in. Low. Low mindset for low people on the low show.
So, Shannon, welcome to the show today. Thank you for joining us.
Mark, I just want to say thank you personally for having me on your show, Mark.
I love you, bro. Mark Hubbard Show, right? But you didn't ask my question. You know a lot about farting, don't you? You got a wife, 6 kids, and grandkids. Could you imagine everybody farting at one time? That thing would be TNT. Poosh.
My wife doesn't fart.
Your wife passed gas. That's right. She's ladies pass gas.
My wife is very, very, very what do you call it? Dignified. She does not. Her body does not do that.
She's dignified. So what she do? She moves out your presence and she goes something like.
Yo, what's wrong with this conversation today? What is going on?
Yeah, DJ Mike, I gave you the cue to play music, so
right,
he missed it. He missed that.
I didn't miss it. Look, let me take it back. So listen, everybody, it's Friday. It's 2 p.m. Of course, it's the Mark Hubbard Show. We are live. We're gonna stop talking about what we were talking about.
Thank you.
Let's get this up real quick, but we'll be back. DJ Mike, Calibus. I'm just saying, though, you know. It's Mark, man. It's Mark in there. Let's go. Listen, everybody. It's Friday, man. Make sure you still wearing your mask. Did you get you a vaccine? If not, don't get it. I'll talk to you. Johnson & Johnson is tearing people up. DJ Mike every single Friday, we right here. She might try to pop that boyfriend's jump, but I don't really care because I know he's a punk. I'll stop him like a roach if he tries to approach. Rest in peace, Heavy D. I'm the one who wrote the book of romance. So come on, take a chance. You don't need a long look. All you need is a glance. If you want to get warm, in my arms you belong. You have a problem, help us solve them. Nothing can go wrong. Wait, bubbles in the house. Listen, I am DJ Mike Calibus every single Friday, 2 p.m. on the Mark Hubbard Show. Let's try that. Y'all gonna get that show started.
We got lovers through and through, and though we made it through the storm, I really want you to be alive. I really want to put you on. I've been searching for someone.
Okay. Like I said, it's Friday.
Be the real love that I need.
Remember that? Just take you back.
Baby, please.
Right now, follow me at DJ Mike Caliber on Instagram. Let's go.
Hey, let's make an eyes.
Trying it out, okay? Listen. Let me just say this real quick before we get back to the show. Let me be very clear. We are not going to talk about what we were talking about anymore. Reg, take it away.
You mean talking about farting?
Well, no. I don't know what you're talking about. Reg, take it away.
What's up? That was
hey, I don't know what you're talking about, Mark.
Great set of music coming from DJ Mike Caliber.
And he farted in between each
other. What'd you say, Mark?
Thank you for that.
No, Reg, it's up to you, Reg.
Music. Thank you for that. Music.
All the way here. You just look like you're in the
hey, man.
Reggie farting in his house.
Oh, my God. You just can't leave it alone.
What's yeah. wrong with me, for real?
So, again, thank you guys for joining us today. Thank you, Shannon, for joining. We have, again, a great set of music for you guys. New music from Shannon, Lowe, and his family. And we have
and they all fart.
Some new music from some other artists that we'll be sharing on today as well. Right now, I'm going to take a listen
to me with a smile. Look at him. You get it. Go ahead, Rich. You're doing it. Look at him. You better talk over me with a smile.
Holy.
You're doing that bad, fella. This is holy.
Oh,
New music, from Mark Hubbard and the Voices Holy. Mark Hubbard and the Voices Holy. Wendell is a part of that project. Shannon is a part of that project. I just typed his brother's name, so that's why I think of Wendell Lowe. But Shannon is a part of that project. Shannon is a part of Mark Hubbard and the Voices. Shannon is a singer-songwriter in his own right. Shannon, man, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I appreciate the opportunity to be on here. I love Mark. I love Reggie. And the whole crew, the whole show is just hilariously funny to me. Y'all really make my Fridays.
Yeah, and Mark wants to say something so bad. You see,
I'm not going to say it right now. I'm just not gonna say it right. I really do, because Shannon has this look on his face, like. But I'm gonna keep it to myself. He just has this look on his face. I'm trying to understand. I don't know if somebody farted in him or something. He looks really tight. I mean, it's a whole tight face, like. I really like my new light bark in the show.
He was trying to find a way to fit that in.
I was
he
not.
Had to. He
I
had to find a way
was not.
To bring
I
that
was
back
not.
Up. He had to find a way to bring that back up.
I was not. I was
yes.
Not. I was not.
You was waited not. For an opportunity.
I did.
I thought Holy was going to take us to a different story.
Oh,
No. Shannon, you know better. Mark will go and come right back, right real fast.
Real fast.
It don't take it's
at
one
all.
Second. One second.
You should. They should hire me to host some of these services and these concerts. I guarantee you, we'd be out on time for real. You know what I mean? They get that bump in by the time they get through shopping. Yep. Here come a joke. You got five. Listen, you got 5 seconds to shout. 5 minutes in full gospel. And once that 5 minutes up, it's a wrap. You can scream if you want to. You can be outside screaming, literally.
Just be screaming by yourself. That's all.
By yourself. As we move on. Huh?
So Shannon. I already know that you know the church experience is part of your upbringing.
How you know, Reggie?
Share with everyone how many brothers and sisters, how many siblings you have.
Well, he being nosy now. Let's see this.
I have a very big family. I am one of 10.
There you go.
I am one of 10. And all of my, I come from I'm a PK. So my father was a pastor. My brothers are all pastors.
That answers a lot.
Not only that, but you guys are a musical family as well.
Yes, we are. Yeah. Originally, my father is an original Tommy, sang with the late great Pastor Milton Bronson, and he passed that music on to me and my siblings. We all sing and play, or do something musical. And then we passed it on to our children and our children's, like the Bible has instructed us.
And children.
So the generations, you all didn't mind the sharing to the generations. I must say, I know the next generation of Lowe's that are coming, and they are amazing. Your children, and then I met one of, I believe, Wendell's sons that plays as well.
Uh-huh.
But you guys are just an amazing group of singers and songwriters and musicians. So
thank you very much.
Kudos. So all of that church all day paid off, huh?
Yeah, you know what? Yeah, it, honestly, it did. Man, I just thinking about even when we were growing up, and then as I got my children, I churched my children all day too. I did. You know, I definitely tortured them. You know, dragging them to like four services on Sunday. Even, you know, I was just talking to my wife about back in the day when she was a part of the voices of the Mark Hubbard and the United Voices Choir. I wasn't a part of but I was around because I was dating my wife. And, you know, first of all, some of his tenors was really reckless toward me, but I ain't going to talk about that, you know.
Oh, you want to talk about it, but keep talking. I'm on the phone right now. You keep talking about it.
Yeah, so, you can defend yourself right now.
You know, I was about just trying to be a supportive boyfriend. And, you know, and I'm you know, because I'm, if everybody knows me, they know I'm short. And they know my wife, they know she's tall. You know, she's 6 feet tall. I'm 5 foot five. So, yeah, I got a lot, you know, but I won in the end.
Yeah, you won in the end. How many years of marriage is it?
26 years. 27 years this year.
Yeah, so you definitely
27 won. Years, yeah. Six children, three grandchildren. Well, one on the way. So three grandchildren.
Congratulations. And you did something over during the pandemic. Share what you did. Share how you brought your family together.
You know, of course, everybody was a little bummed out because we wasn't able to gather. So I tried to be a little creative in how to do something with my family. And I wanted to include my whole family. But that's a lot of people, you know. We joke about it, but it seriously is a lot of people. So my six children, my nine other siblings, their children, we kind of went in the studio at different times, and I wrote the song about family, and because family is what we are, and I think it's a beautiful song. And it really talks about the essence of my family, but it also just talks about the essence of what I believe to be everybody's philosophy towards their family, or at least where it should be, or where I would love for it to be.
Awesome. Now, how many singers did you have that are a part of the project? I know you guys weren't all there at the same time. But how many singers are a part of the final project?
There are, I think there's a total of like 30 of us all together on this.
And that's still scaled back, right?
yeah, that's scaled back. So that's really, we had so many people that weren't able to be involved. Because this is only pretty much most of the Chicago people. I have relatives that are in Detroit. I have relatives that are in New York. And these, I'm not talking about like distant relatives. These are you know, really close, you know, cousins nieces and nephews. So, we want to do something that we can include everyone in the future, that is in the planning, hopefully to do something and release it around family time, Thanksgiving. So,
okay. Yeah. Okay. Now, with the production, so I know the family is singing. What about the instruments? What about the production.
Yeah, this entire project is 100% Lowe family, from pre-production to mixing and mastering. Produced by myself and Cameron, my son Cameron, and my nephew Jeremy Allen. Also, you know, Chantrell gave some input. All of the singers, of course, is all family. We recorded it in my nephew's studio, Jeremy Allen. He's a, you know, great producer and everything. And God has really blessed him with the equipment and the know-how. And I just really wanted to utilize, you know, my family on all of this. And, you know, my philosophy really about it was, you know, even if it's not great to the world, it's going to be great to my family, because it's all literally 100% of our family that's on here and doing this.
All right. And how appropriate that the single is titled Family.
Yeah.
So we're going to take a listen to it, set it up for us, and we're going to play it.
Okay. It's a song, great song. If you got your family, get your family around, listen to the song, adopt the philosophy. Family by the Lowe family.
That starts together. Yes.
What you've got in you that's always gonna keep us together. Whoa, whoa,
whoa. And what's in you?
And what you got in you that's never gonna drive us apart.
Oh,
and what's in me?
What you got in you that's always gonna last forever.
Oh, it ain't going nowhere.
What is that inside of you that's blowing straight from your heart?
Related.
Well, the same thing that's in you, it lives in me.
It's the ball.
So much deeper than what the eyes can see.
We're more of the same.
We're so much more of the same.
We talk a lot. We act a lot. We sing a lot. It's because we're family.
My man, my how do we manage to accomplish so much, so little?
We never had a lot growing up.
How do we find strength when you really wanna fall apart?
And sometimes things are just so crazy.
Fighting isolation and the times we want to be alone by ourselves.
Well, it's just running high.
It doesn't feel good to always carry burdens on your own.
Sometimes we try to, but it don't feel good to carry all of that.
Sometimes we might get mad and real angry.
We may get upset with each other.
We may fuss, we may even.
And block each other from phone calls.
Disagree. I might say some words that's not my true feelings. Hey.
Be there for each other.
Thick and thin, we lose, we win.
Yes. We'll still be there for family.
When times get hard, things get rough. We
you will, and we will. I will survive. Because God, He placed us together.
Thank you for our family.
Thank God for this family, this
Lowe family, his music family, my family, Scott.
A great song, family. That is Shannon Lowe and family, right here on the Mark Hubbard Show. Yeah, great song, Shannon. Great song. You wrote it. You know, teaching your family couldn't have been a hard task. I mean, a family of singers, it couldn't have been a hard task.
You know what? When it's working with our family, I never use teaching. I think because whenever we gather, our gatherings are always creative.
Come mm-hmm. on.
They're always kind of spiritual, musical, and creative. And we just do it just by our natural, it's our natural element. We sit around the table and we end up singing something, or somebody's doing something, beating on something, and it always turns to the creative side of things with our family, and that's not just my family. When we grew up, we were riding around in my dad had a 15 passenger van. Because we needed a van. We had so many kids, of course. But we would be singing.
Shannon.
Yeah.
Betty Lowe is watching.
Hey, that's my mama.
Hey, Mother Lowe.
Mama Lowe.
I just want you to know, Mama Lowe watching. Mama Lowe. From this point, better be good. That's my birthday, twin.
Yes. That's right.
Yes.
Libras, special Libras.
What's the part about the special? What do you mean by that? Because, you know, I could call Betty.
Special to me.
Oh, okay. Fix it up. You know, fix it up. Because, you know, she'll get you.
So 10 deep in a 15 passenger van. How was that? I mean, just.
You know what? It was crazy. I don't know. People say, I don't know how I did it. I don't know how they did it, because we'd be in the car. We ain't had no air conditioning in the house. We was like 4 to a bedroom when we were growing up sometime. And it was crazy. Kudos to Betty Lowe and Wendell Lowe Sr., you know, for really keeping it together with us. They made growing up so much fun, even though they taught us so much. I ain't gonna lie. They beat us too. I was gonna say they beat the hell out of us, but it wasn't like that.
Yeah, that's what you guys say. You weren't gonna say they beat the hell out of us.
That's what was coming. Now on the same token, you know, families always have this thing. And parents always say, well, I don't have a favorite. All of y'all my favorite. But Shannon, who was the favorite?
I am the favorite. Hands down. I'm the baby boy.
Why is that, Shannon?
You take a poll with the Lowe family. I am the favorite.
You're the favorite.
I didn't do a project. I didn't put everybody's voice on Front Street.
You can't hear nothing.
I put everybody's voice on Front Street. None of my family has done that, so I am the favorite. I don't care what nobody else say. I'm the favorite.
Lazy, can you hear me?
Yeah. So you're the favorite. Uh-oh. Omega said, please stop.
Yeah.
Nancy said,
it was great. Oh, Reggie. You know, yeah. You should have made him last. The whole Lowe family, that's a clan right there. You should have made him last. Stop the interview and make him come back at the end of the show so you still have viewers.
The Lowe family is representing the Lowe family.
Yes, they family reunion. That's a clan by themselves. You should have made him last, dude. I know there's so many people. He's spoiled. Yeah.
Mama Lowe said you're spoiled.
He is. That is.
I am.
Really.
I am spoiled. My mother still called me. That's my baby. I am my mother's baby. Yes. I was the only one and she'll classify this, that did not give her any labor pains at birth.
Oh, when you got here.
I have to admit, because I was last, so.
Hey. Oh, but when you got here, that's when the pain started.
Well, well, okay. So that's so you will admit the other favorite. That's amazing. It's always one of those things with families. I'm the favorite, mama, you the favorite. Yeah, so oh, okay, mama said that was true. So yeah, family is everything, and we thank you for sharing your family with us today, and music from your family. And we wish you you guys the very best. We know there's a lot more great things coming for the Lowe family. Share some of the things that your children have done, TV appearances, traveling the world, et cetera, et cetera.
Yes, my Cameron, he is the one who co-produced this project with me. He is a man. He's a beast of a musician and arranger and everything. And he's only 19 years old. And he has the favor to play for Mark Hubbard in the Voices also. But he also plays for so many artists. He got a chance to do Coachella before the pandemic with some of the artists that he was playing with. Smino, and he played with a lot of artists that I don't know, because I really don't listen to that kind of music, but that's okay because they checks clear, so I don't have a problem with it. My daughter Kristen, she sings with Donald and Dante Hall and a lot of different people. Shantina Lene, who's been on the show, she has so many different stuff, so much stuff out, you know. And I'm proud of my kids. They're doing their thing musically. They're building their name, their own name. It's the low name, but they're building on their own, you know. Just like the tree that branches out, you know. They're not sitting up here saying, "Okay, my daddy is Shannon Lowe, so you got to do." They ain't doing that. Mm-mm. They out there, you know, they hitting the bricks themselves, and I'm really proud of them. And even though we don't see eye to eye all the time on, like, the genre of the music, it's not about the genre. It's about the gift that God gives to you, for you to, like the Bible says about the talents. You take the talent that God gives to you, and then you make more out of it. And that's what they've done. That's what we've done. And I love that about my children. I'm very, very proud of
them. Awesome, awesome. Now we have another guest that's joining us today on today's show, Leland. We're going to bring him in, Leland.
All
and
right.
Then we have music that we are going to share from Shantina Lene. And so we're going to switch it up a little bit. You just talked
Hello?
About we love.
Oh, can I start?
Hello.
I'm here. Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Oh, yeah, I can hear you.
Is that a big old microphone?
What this is a giant microphone that I lovingly call the box.
What?
I speak into the box and wonderful things come out. I should be coming out extra clear on your end. Is that right?
If you don't get off this show with that box.
No, I can't drop the box, man.
so Leland, we'll be ready.
Are you in the bedroom?
Yeah.
Make your bed up. That's what I can tell.
I didn't make the bed up.
That bed is not made up. Don't you go.
Come on. Mark going to find something, man. He going to find something.
I'm going to show that big old box that the bed ain't made up.
Man. So what we're going to do, we're going to take a listen to Sexy, and this is from Shantina Lene, and then we're going to come back and talk to you.
What is going on in this show? People, get him out of here. Just make your bed up.
Uninterested, head in my hands, cause my mind needs a rest. But I pick up for you cause I like your aesthetic. Got me invested, can't take my eyes and my mind off you. Mind if I treat you like work or some time? Feels like we on the same hearts. I think I'm ready to leave my own bed and jump right in your head. Call me Freddy, I'm ready cause you're so sexy. Your body's perfect for me. And I want it now. Sexy all night. Perfect for me. For me, yes. Baby. You do me almost as good as I do. Got me last to say matching. I got that's you. The way you can't quit. So unexpected. Can't put your second. My legs in different directions. I know you got it, but I'ma get on top of you. I'll be the captain. Yeah. You can be my passenger. As it stands, you're too in demand. You holding out on what I need. What I can't withstand. Your body's perfect, and I want it now. All night, work it. I want you to work it, cause yeah, no other time will be worth it. Don't ask no questions, baby. Come on, baby, baby. Oh, just work it, work it.
Music from Santina Lene. Santina Lene.
I just want you to know the timing of that song could not have been worse. Sexy with him, and this man got his bed showing, and it's not made up. The timing of the song is the worst. It's great. The song is great.
Santina is a great song.
It's a great song. Great singer from a great family. I want to hear the gospel version of it. Sexy. But my thing right now is that it's the time of the song. Can you get and this and then get? Oh Lord, I don't know what to do.
No, what I want, what I'm curious to know. I'm curious to know how Mama Lo feels about the song.
Hey, Mama Lo, she loves, we let her hear the uncut version of these songs, and some of them are like Shantina got this song called Ride. And we had to let Mama Lo hear that, and she was like,
okay. So she didn't hear that line in this song that put your legs all over the place.
I'm sorry, Mama Lo kind of don't care as long as you know Mama Lo is riding in luxury, you know.
This conversation is with too far. I don't know where we're going.
I'm just playing, Mom. I'm just playing. I love you, Mom.
You were the favorite.
Yeah, you were the favorite.
Oh my God.
Oh, wait a minute.
She said.
She did let Grandma hear.
But you know what? You know
can
what?
Can we say something though? Can we just put all the cards on the table in Jesus' name? He doesn't have 9 siblings without Mama.
What's going on? Listen, right? Okay, huh?
About me?
Okay, listen.
Mama, they're not talking about me.
Mama knows. Like, listen, Mama Lo, what are you doing? Mama Lo, like, listen, child, listen. I listen. That's my point that she keeps saying. She know. You know, that's not Betty Mary, Mother of Jesus. That's not Betty Mary, Mother of Jesus. That's not Mama Lo. No,
the Lowe house is always a happy house.
And Mama Lo says, I might not always approve, but they are.
See, I love y'all. Mama said, I love y'all. Mama Lo said, I love y'all. She knows what's going
on. And that's the thing. Music. Music is good music. It depends, Shantina, keep doing what you do, and keep on excelling. It's great music, and it's never gonna be for everybody. It's never gonna be for everybody, but you do have an audience that you're gonna reach, and that's it.
But it says your gift will make room for you. It never said your gift will make room for you only in the church. It never said that. Right. That's exactly. Not said in the Bible. So we got to try to get all deep down where, you know, the gift is just this. It says your gift will make room for you and position you before great men. It didn't say great men in the church. That's not what the Bible says. Huh?
Preach, Mark.
Amen.
On the nerve.
Okay,
and then we get in the church, and then we get back.
Collection plate.
Hold on. Listen, it's called Cash App. It'll be down in a few minutes.
It'll be down in a few minutes.
Listen, it'll be down in a few minutes. Don't think y'all, there it is right there. Go around Cash App, the Mark Hubbard Show. Go ahead and sow a seed. But it gets them alive. Let the saints, leave the saints alone.
Yes, leave them alone.
Leave them alone. Let them go and express themselves. As long as they're not hurting nobody, let them express themselves. Because you know y'all don't want to pay them nothing in the church, so let them go out there.
Come on. Hey, facts, bro. On phone now.
Take this love offering.
The sanctuary took all their money back now. Yeah, I'm about not getting nothing.
Yeah. Your Cash App to stop. But here, take this love offering and go get you a sandwich.
Listen, but seriously, and let me just clarify, because you know the saints get deep. Not all of them are like that, but a lot of them are. They don't know how to appreciate the gift, and then when the gift walks out and move out and go through something different, then we get upset, then we want to send them all to hell. But we don't appreciate them while they're here and doing what they're supposed to do. So, and that's not everybody. That's not everybody. If my mom says the shoe fit, then wear. If it don't, then just put it to a side. All right. That's not everybody. All church folks are not the same. But there are some of us out here that would like literally say, my mom should say she was a bishop, would prostitute your gift and won't help you out. That's what they do. They will. I need to take my medicine. No, I didn't take
it. Please take.
Right. So again.
But not everybody, but some will. And then they get mad when you want to go, and when you go to someplace else. Huh? No. Yeah. You keep on being sexy.
I'm done.
So Shantina has a lot of other music that's out and available on iTunes. So go check it out, as well as Kristen, amazing singer. Kristen has done which show did Kristen do? American
she
Idol.
She did Sunday Best.
She did Sunday Best. Yes. Amazing. And we're excited to see what's coming from the next generation that's on their way. So we're excited to see what's coming. So again, Shannon, thank you for joining us. Thank you for presenting your music. It's great music. And you have some other great music as well that you've written. Shannon, how long have you been writing songs?
it seems like I've been writing for all of my life, but I started seriously writing probably when I became about 19 years old, after I met my wife, and then we wrote stuff together. So see, I wasn't even trying to be funny like that.
That's obvious.
She pulled something out of me, you know, almost literally. See, this is not going good.
Cover all of your ears.
Because Shannon.
Lord.
Okay, I'm gonna mute myself right now and just.
Grown folks is talking right now.
Right. You should have known Mark was gonna take it to the left.
Way left. She's your muse. She's your inspiration. I get it. I get it. Thank you again.
Thank you, Reggie. Appreciate that. Let everybody know where the
song is available at. Shannon, where's the song available to purchase for download?
Right now, the song is on all media, all digital outlets, iTunes, Apple Music for the iPhone users, you know, Google Play, Spotify for the Androids, and for the people, Yeah, it's on YouTube. It's on everywhere. So, yeah, send me $1.29 for it. Yeah, I appreciate it. God bless
you. Let me hold a dollar.
Please support family, and that's you'll be able to find it under Shannon Lowe Family. Check it out. As you heard on today's show, it's a great song. It's a great song.
Full project coming in November.
Okay, awesome. Awesome. We'll be looking out for that, and we'll definitely have you back on the show to talk about the full project. So you don't have to go anywhere. We're going to talk to Leland for a minute. Leland, you're from the church world as well.
Absolutely.
So you're no stranger to the conversation we just had.
Oh, no.
So thank you for joining us today and being a part of today's show. You're a engineer, producer. Share a little bit about who Leland is.
So I am a producer, engineer, MC from Chicago. Also a gospel hip-hop artist. I've been making music for about 14 years now. Surprise, fun fact. I am literally only 1 year older than Mr. Shannon Lowe's marriage. So that is, you know, fun fact.
Well,
that
is what it is.
Yep.
You can be one of my kids.
I'm 28, man. It's crazy. I know people think I'm old, but I'm not. Anyways, been following Jesus since I was 19. And yeah, man, I just make music for the Lord and making hip hop for the Lord, which is already controversial enough as it is. But yeah.
Yeah. So hip hop, I managed a hip hop artist that was doing gospel. And yeah, it's that's reserved for Fifth Sunday youth service.
Yep.
Saturday night.
Yep. Youth conference.
The youth conference. But it's not for Sunday morning service.
Wait, what?
Mark is really having a problem with the mic.
Why?
Hold it up.
It's almost bigger than your face.
I mean, it is.
It is
as big as my face.
I mean,
but it sounds so good. It just sounds amazing.
Clarity is undeniable, but
it's, yeah. I mean, bro, like, come on, man. Like, I can literally take this and go straight to podcast. Like, I barely have to mix it.
Take some.
Wait, what?
Take some
the what?
The light. You can't see you. No mic is in the dark. We can see that. We can see your beard, though. It's unmade, but we can't.
I knew it. He just wanted to come back to the bed, man.
I saw that when he wasn't on the camera yet. I wasn't going to tell him nothing about that because I knew you was going to talk about it.
Yeah. You see when he made the bed up, though. You can see that he did do a little bit of that.
Yeah, I saw it, but I ain't say nothing about it. That's
right. Turn the light on.
The light is on.
You gotta be over there in the bed because that's what light is.
No, stay where you at. Stay where you at. Never mind. Yeah. So next time, invest into a big light. I love to go along with that big mic.
So Leland, you had something amazing happen to you. Share what with the audience. What happened? I mean, this is
so
long.
It's been crazy. So last month, no, actually February, I made a remix to a song from a TV show called WandaVision. It was on Disney Plus, you know, huge nerd event, you know, blurreds, nerds, they know about it. So I remixed a song that was from the show, and it's called Agatha All Along. Now, they had put out Agatha All Along by itself, you know, a week later, and it shot to the top of the charts. But I made the remix before they put out the original version. That's an important thing. I put out the original version on Saturday. Sunday, it was at 10,000 views. I was like, okay, this is cool. All right, you know, I'm a local artist. You know, Mr. Hubbard, you know, has seen me for years in the local scene here in the city. You know, he knows, both of you know, where I come from. So, you know, that Sunday, it had 10,000 views. But when I came back, I left out. When I came back in the house Sunday night, it was at 100,000 views. I was like, oh, this is different. And literally, it had gained 100,000 views every day until that Wednesday. Wow. Like, so many quote tweets, so many retweets. And then not only that, it got picked up by the news. It got picked up by Yahoo. It got picked up by BuzzFeed. It was everywhere. Wait one more time.
I'm talking to Lady D. Can you put my Cash App up there? Because he's got, he got that ching ching going on with all these. Apparently, he wants to store into the ministry. He's a church boy. You know, since we've been seeing him all along, let him store into this ministry.
Because we like to get paid.
Listen. Hey, all I did was go viral. Ain't nobody cut the check yet. going viral is not a check. I know y'all, you know what I'm saying? That just means people saw what you did. You know, that's all. One of the cast members actually danced to my beat. Her name is Tayana Paris, and she plays Monica Rambeau on the show. You know, she was known and, on Broadway and, did all the stuff. And I got this superstar dancing to my beat on Instagram, and everybody's like, "Oh, bro, you did it!" And I'm like, "Wow, I was literally in Bible study as that is happening. I'm in Bible study mixing service, and she danced to my beat and put it on Instagram. I'm wow." And then like I ain't gonna say the crowning moment, but it felt real good. So the original songwriters of Agatha All Along, they are Kristen and I'm not gonna butcher their name, so I'm not gonna try to remember it. But it's a husband and wife duo, and they wrote "Let It Go" from Frozen. Everybody, let it go, let it go. Everybody know that song.
Don't do that.
Don't do that. Just talk. I knew y'all was gonna do that, man.
Oh, come on.
So they wrote "Let It Go." They wrote so many. I mean, they wrote so many Disney hits, and they talked about me in the New York Times.
Wow!
And I was just like, "Look at God!" Because somebody just played an organ. You got an organ for me, DJ? You got something for me? I was just like, ain't got no organ. I mean, something, but I mean, I was just like, "Look at God."
First of all, he doesn't work for you, so no.
No,
you, no, none of that. You just keep
can't let me vibe, Mr. Hubbard, man.
No, you're not
can't let me vibe, bro.
No, you don't vibe on my dad. You just keep telling your story. I just didn't know the story gonna end.
But yeah, that's that happened. And so I was very grateful.
That's pretty cool. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, Shannon, they got in that car. Because when I tell you that boy, he was making me nervous. He didn't walk outside. He didn't get in the car. I was just like, Shannon, sit down. Be still.
We're going to take a listen to it. This is Agatha of the Trap Hip Hop Remix. So take a listen to it. Trapaholics mixtape.
Sparky too.
So you would have had to watch.
Okay, what was that?
That's it.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, that's it. That's it. WandaVision. It was a pretty good show. I did catch it on Disney Plus. If you are a Marvel fan, then you will enjoy it once you get past the first couple of episodes, because I got lost with the first couple of episodes, so I had to get past the first couple of episodes, but it was good. So kudos to that. Now, has what's happened as a result of that going viral? Have you seen an uptick in your old music that you've done previously? Share.
What he got, man? what you got, Uncle Mark?
He's talking about me. So go ahead.
No, I'm not. It's just both of y'all. Can we get to the interview? Can we get on with this interview?
Here it is. So I've obviously got
I know stupid. I'm talking wrong with me for real. Like Jesus, if this ain't ever get to the story. Like, does Disney cost?
Does Disney cost?
Disney Plus cost?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
$8 a month.
Hold on, Saints. Hold on, Saints. Hold on. That was a question. I have Amazon Prime, that's what I asked. It's what it costs. That's why I'm seeing the show. Keep going.
All right. So yeah, I've gotten, you know, more clients. You know, definitely more subscribers. And you know, just a moment like that, you know, just the moment itself, you know, I had, you know, I know we're saints here, but I can't even begin to tell you spiritually what that moment was doing for me, you know, mm-hmm. because that the week following the drop, I had felt rejected and I knew it. I knew I was being rejected. I knew that the people that I was like really like looking to like support the music was like, we not rocking with you, dog. And this is like, you know, what can I do? And then I dropped the beat that changed my life. Dude, you know, that's
in all sincerity, dog. That happens a lot. Cause you know, I was actually just talking to my choir about this on Thursday, how you can feel so overlooked, how you feel so disconnected, feel like, man, it's just not going to happen for me. And then out of nowhere, God would send somebody to bless you that you did not even expect to bless you. So understand, I mean, seriously, now this is a serious moment, so catch it, because it's not going to happen often. Seriously, God would, you know, I tell the truth. Man, God would blow your mind, and it is true. My pastor always preaches about he can put you on the mind of somebody that you wouldn't even think is going to have you on their mind. You would get a blessing from an unexpected blessing from somebody that you don't know is going to, but somebody somewhere is calling your name, speaking your name, and is designed to bless you. So man, yeah, this is great. I'm glad it's happened for you, man. This is really good stuff.
Thank you, man.
And it's a testament to just not take what somebody else is saying about you, but just keep going and have that passion and keep the passion and don't let anyone discourage you because it might not have been meant for them, but
right.
There you go.
The timing is always in God's hand, the timing of it. And, you know, you'll get a whole lot of no's before you get that right yes. So it's just okay. You know?
All it needs to be just that one right yes.
Just the one.
Right yes.
That's it.
I promise you.
So congratulations. Congratulations. Yeah. Leland has been an avid supporter of Next Showcase and things that we've been doing. So when he shared that he went viral, I had to bring him on to talk to him just to show some support back to him and what he's doing. So. Thank you.
Enjoy this moment because you probably won't be back anytime soon.
Get out of here. All right, fine, man.
But Leland, you don't have to go anywhere. Share with everyone where they can go and listen to it, go and stream it.
Yeah. So you can go on any social media platform, just type in Leland Philpott, like you see on the screen. I do this little thing. It's called, you know, this is what I do. I say Leland like the street, Phil like Collins, and Pot like of water. Leland Phil Pot, and you'll be able to find me everywhere.
That's what the pot is like, Lady D. Yeah, you know it. That's not what he used that pot for. That's not what he said. That
okay.
Pot.
All right. Okay. Okay.
Laugh for no reason, for real.
Leland, again, thanks for joining us.
Nice.
And again, congratulations on that, and best wishes in what you have coming up.
Absolutely, thank you, guys.
How much you already know? How much I pay for what? The desk chair.
The desk chair. Oh, this is cheap. This is a cheapo. It's like $150 or something. This ain't nothing.
Does it support your back?
I want a better pair. Yo, if y'all want it sold to me, hey, cash out. If y'all want to help me get a new chair, I got a cash out too, man.
We want to help you get a light and a better and a smaller mic.
Right. $150 ain't nothing. How much that mic cost?
Oh, you know what? It was crazy is that this whole thing is not a mic. It's actually a mic shield. You see what I mean? Like, this is the shield. What's inside is the mic.
Oh, my God.
So, yeah, it's some tech. But there's a reason why it sounds so gorgeous. And I know it does.
So we
I know
fit,
y'all hating.
And we can't fit one of these Corona mic covers over there.
Yeah, oh, what is that?
That's the mic cover.
Oh no, see, single use only. This is for me. This is the box.
You're right, and nobody want to use it but you. I can carry
a big strong arm after carrying that thing around.
Right.
That's fine.
All right, family, we're gonna take a listen to new music from Kalante Gavin. This is great.
You leaving?
You don't have to leave. Stick around.
I got another.
Well, I was saying about.
Somebody clap your hand, yo. How many of you know we serve a great God? Yeah. Hey. Oh, there's no name on the Jesus name, and throughout the land, we will now proclaim that our God is King. He reigns in majesty. Now we all can say that our God is great. We call you great. We call you great. We call you mighty. We call you great. There's no other. That He is our King. Now we all can say that our God is great. Everybody, help me right here. We call you great. Oh, we call you great. We call you mighty. We call you great.
You're the first and the last. We say, yeah.
right. That was new music from Kalante Gavin. He has a new project, new full project that's out and available. We want you guys to support all of the music that we played here on the Mark Hubbard Show and that we play each week. We want you to support it. We want you to support the artist. You can purchase all of the music on any digital outlet, Google Play, Apple App Store, wherever you purchase your music is available there. We put the name up so you guys can see the name of the artist and the name of the song. So go support the artist. Go support the artist.
Hey, Destiny. Hey, Destiny.
She wanted you to know she was here.
And she did. You hear me? So, hold up, Reggie.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna have a serious moment here for real. Mm-hmm. I know Lady D, she got to talk, but with DJ Mike and guys, so let's talk about this week. This week has literally been another week for the books.
Yeah, definitely a roller coaster.
We had, we talked about here in Chicago, the 13-year-old boy that was killed by a police officer. Then we talk about the 20-year-old young man in Minnesota that was killed by the police officers. And then we had
the lieutenant that was pulled over by the police and pepper sprayed.
And then let's talk about the young man. I think I told you about also that got pulled over. Now let's listen to this. He got pulled over because he was driving 65 miles an hour in a 70 mile hour zone. So he got pulled over because he was driving 5 miles below the speed limit.
Mm-hmm.
Because that was a caution of suspicion to the white sheriff,
who wanted to know where he was going,
where he was coming from, and talk about his job. And he kept saying, "So what does this have to do with you pulling me over?" And then he comes back and gives him a
warning that he said that you can throw away whenever you get to a garbage can.
Yeah. But I want to give you a warning. So he gets out the car. The young man says, "But what is the warning for? You still have not told me why you are issuing me this citation or whatever it's called. Because again, you're gonna pull me over because I was driving 5 miles under the speed limit."
And so then let's talk about the young man that's walking in the neighborhood.
Yeah,
that is stopped by the Caucasian because
Mike can't hear you.
No, I wasn't Mike, talking. I'm not saying anything, yo.
Because you don't belong in this neighborhood. We are a tight knit neighborhood. What are you doing over here?
Mike has that look on his face like he's really upset about it.
I'm over everything, man. I'm moving to Jamaica. I don't even have much to say. You dig? Just be safe out there, black men.
It's tough, man. And I get you, Mike. No, seriously, on all sincerity, I get it. Like, seriously,
it becomes overwhelming.
I can't even walk through a neighborhood. I can't walk through a neighborhood in which, according to the report, that he lives in. So right. He can't walk through a neighborhood that he lives in, regardless of what he lives in or not. He was walking down the street, minding his own business, from what we can see. So we can't do that. So you, being an army, whatever, grown man, twice the young boy's size, you want to get
the size. Yeah.
Pick on him and push him.
The best advice somebody ever told me is get yourself a gun.
License
to kill. And good at the same time, man. It's no ifs, ands, or buts about it.
It's sad. It's very sad, and we're praying for all of the families, definitely, because the mom had just bought the young man in Minnesota the car, and when you send your son out, you want them to come back home.
When you go out, you want to come back home.
Exactly.
That's true. There's no guarantee when I go out.
Let me tell you something. I have one of my sons getting ready to be 28 next month. He has his own place, his own car, and I still don't let him go some places because you can't trust people. I guess no, it don't matter how careful he is, or he where he is trying not to stay, you know, stay away from people. But people are crazy, people and then crazy. They'd be like, "Well, why he grown?" Okay.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Okay, but the people that he go around might not act grown.
Yeah, when, so, when, that's a good point. Post the PTSD is a real thing. If you should happen to be driving and you see a police behind you, automatic, I don't care if you got your insurance, your license, everything is good. You automatically like, oh God, I hope they don't stop me.
And if they do stop, and if they do stop, you're not taking your hand off the steering wheel. Give me your license. Nope, I'm not moving. Because you're scared. Because if you make a gesture, now we can't make a gesture, but they of another persuasion, another cut, they can make all they want. They can actually threaten you and tell you that I'm gonna shoot you, and twice. They still won't do anything to you.
I can tell you that twice.
I can tell you that twice, and they won't do anything.
Pull off,
right?
And pull off, and still be alive to tell it.
Still be alive to tell you. That's just bad. But just getting back to now, even back to boy in Minnesota, and just show you how it's double standard. And I promise we're gonna move on. So now they talk about a case about an African American man who accidentally, as they said, killed a white woman. He got 12 years for murder, something like that. Now this cop is going to get manslaughter, and I think it's third degree manslaughter. And what I understand is up to 10 years or a $20,000 fine.
There's no justice. It continues to devalue the life of African Americans. The guy that was in
you can put a Glock and a pistol, you really and a taser, literally, seriously, and you've been 26 years on the force, literally.
And there was a clip of a police officer showing his taser, showing his gun. He did it twice. He showed his gun on one side, his taser on the other side, and he himself said, "There's a weight difference. If you cannot tell the difference between a taser and a gun, then you should not be carrying either. If you can't tell the difference between the two, you shouldn't be carrying them." She was a training officer. That's right. Sad.
She was out on the training session. That's the sad part about it. She was with she was out with them training them, and this is what you're teaching them to do. And yeah, this is as I tell people, and this was the other thing I saw about it. So if you really pay attention to the clip, she's holding the gun.
You see the
taser. She's looking at it saying taser.
And it's a gun. It
more times before she even pulls the trigger. So she's got to see she's got to feel that. I mean, a drill and a no drill, you got to see in front of you. It's not yellow, it's black.
It's heavy.
I don't understand that. And I know we want to move on and talk about it. I use my frustration for you guys. I need to just get that off my mind. I'm like with Mike. It's just at the point that I think we're just all over it.
This is right down the street from where the trial for George Floyd is going on. And again, I say again, I'm really, really, really praying that they do not let him off, because America is going to be Chicago is already boarding up. In preparation for, they already have a plan in place for the announcement of the Derek Chauvin trial. It's not going to be a good day.
It's not. If he gets anywhere near, not being guilty, it's not going to be good in America. Period. It's just not going to be. It's just not going to be.
I believe I saw the video that you were talking about where. You know, we always saying that it's just a couple of bad apples, just bad apples, bad apples. Where are the good apples at? And then what's wrong with the tree if it's
exactly. We keep talking about the apples,
bad apples.
But we, as I said before, we keep talking about the apples, but we fail to realize the apple is coming from the tree. So the thing about it is the problem is the tree. So if the cops. Yeah, they are the bad apples, but the problem is the system. The system is the tree.
Allows them to continue to do it.
This allows them to keep doing. So you keep the bad. Yeah, there's a few bad apples, but the bad apples is on a tree with the good apples. So the problem is not the apples so much; it's the system, which is the tree. We need to fix that tree, and it does not It is not in our favor at all. And we keep seeing that over and over and over again.
Well, it was never built to be in our favor.
Yeah. But, you know, after 45 made it certain that y'all knew it was not in our favor.
Yeah.
Because it came so,
we are definitely praying for all of the affected families, even the guy in Racine that was shot in the back by the officer. The officer is back patrolling again. He's working again. So, yeah. Black and being a black male in America, being black in America, is something. It's something. So you guys be careful when you go out. Everyone be careful. Be mindful of your surroundings. Yeah.
Yeah. So I just had to, mention that. I had to talk about that because at all that we're talking about right now, at the end of the day, we are definitely praying. This is how we're going to end for this sort of conversation, seriously, for the families, because those are mothers who either kissed their sons or said something to their sons, goodbye, you know, see you later, in the process, a thought process that they will walk back through the door, but instead they get a phone call. You know, and no parent wants to bear that child. No parent. That's just it's just not how we know life. It's not how like we pitch a life to be. We pitch a life to be that they're gonna, you know, bury us and continue on. We never pitch in life that we would, especially at young ages of 13 and 20. No parent 20. Don't should we have to go through that unnecessarily? They just shouldn't have to go through that. You know, so our prayers and our thoughts is what I'm trying to say. Our thoughts and prayers are continuing with the families, and it's with our black young black men, our black women, and just our race in general. Just we want to continue to pray for the black and brown community. We just want to continue to pray for everybody. You know, that God would just really, you know, I pray constantly for every like all y'all on here. I know we are laughing, joke, but I pray for my team because I understand that, you know, we all do different things. You know, I pray for Mike because Mike is, he's great at what he does, but you also go in different areas. I know he can protect himself, but he's also DJ. You know, people act crazy in clubs. You know what I'm saying? So I pray that God covers him. You know, we all live in different areas and do things. We can just walk outside our door.
Right.
It's guaranteed. So, you know, I continue to pray for everybody that God will continue to cover us. We'll definitely cover my team and my family and everybody that's connected to us. So again, guys, we're praying for those families. You all continue to pray for them as well. That's all I have to say.
Yep. And thank you guys for joining us again. This is the Mark Hubbard Show. We are here every Friday from 2 p.m. until about 3:30 p.m. Bringing you some of the best in music, conversation, and a whole lot of laughs. I don't know how it started today. And
I just said because Mike is quiet now, but when he first came on, he started off by saying the fart face. And so he started.
So you putting it off?
No, paint the picture clear. You made this ridiculous face, and you turned right. Look like somebody was stalking you. And I said, "Yo, he pooed it."
He brought it up. He brought it up.
I got it a poo.
You took it from there. You've been running a marathon for 2 hours.
First of all, you did not say I pooed it. You said I farted. That's not what you said.
Okay, I apologize. You farted. You've been running a marathon with it for 2 hours. It was like you had to get it off your chest.
Yes.
He was like, I got to talk about this.
Yes.
If he would have said pooed it, he probably would have made fun of that word. So either way it went.
But it was not my fault. I did not start the conversation. And then, you know what I'm sick of y'all doing too. Let me tell you what y'all do. So like we was talking to Shannon, and he kept saying keywords. Every time he said keywords, y'all start laughing at me, knowing that the same thought process went through y'all minds. And that's what really pisses me off. It just does. Because you, it's like, you know, it does. It just upsets me. And like, you know, and my thing is, so man, I think it's not so easy. So y'all the one that can go off. That ain't me.
Because we know by now.
We know where your mind is going.
So wait
a minute. When Shannon said she pulled something out of me, I was like, oh.
Okay, it's over.
Shannon, please, this is not going to end well.
I didn't say that. I didn't say it, though. I didn't say that. It's like every time somebody
comes. We already knew.
No, but anybody come on here and have keywords, y'all always try to blame it on me when it's y'all minds be going there.
Yeah, but you always take it out of our mind and put it out.
How?
We don't think that you do.
How? Listen,
it's okay, Mark. How? Let me answer this for you. How?
Oh, now you want to talk.
Just the way you do. You just do it. It just is that.
Okay. So it's my fault.
And then because he take his picture off the screen, but don't mute it so we can hear him.
Can that thing be tickling me? Can that thing be tickling me? Because it all be about y'all faces like, oh my God.
So yeah.
Again, not my fault. It's just, you know, it's just certain keywords that y'all, and y'all just go right there. Y'all go there, not me.
So again, lots of laughs. So join us again next week. We'll be right back here.
We sure will.
With some more laughs. If you guys are not busy, if you guys are, even if you are busy, get a ticket for our showcase on Tuesday, April 20th, 7 p.m. We will be doing a pre-show at 6 o'clock p.m. So check us out. Check us out. You can go to nextshowcaseusa.com to purchase your ticket, or you can download the app Next Showcase. It's on the Apple App Store as well as Google Play. Search Next Showcase. Purchase your ticket. It's only $5 to purchase a virtual ticket. Doesn't matter where you are, you can watch the show.
Can you tell? Mike got a new thing now, Lady D. When he ready, he stands up. You see that? He got that new.
Look, he started moving. He ready. Moving.
So nosy, man.
He said, "No, I'm so nosy. I just pay attention. You have to pay attention to cues. So I can't. That's his cue." And now, you know, now his new cue is he stands up, he starts turning, and then, you know, he's ready for Reggie to stop talking, for me to shut up so he can play his music and get out of here because he's not going to say goodbye. He's just going to hang up.
And they call that preparation, okay? Preparation.
But you stop preparing a little earlier so we won't take it personal. Stop preparing a little earlier so we won't take it personal.
Stop preparing earlier?
Yes.
So, guys.
Stop preparing earlier?
He's prepared.
Look, you heard him laugh already.
Oh,
got it.
He's thinking this church.
So on that note, DJ Mike is on you. See you guys next week. Y'all have a great one.
All right, yeah. Listen, thank you, Mark. We appreciate that today. We really, really do. Okay. Shout out to everybody, man. Every single Friday, like Reg said, every single Friday, 2 p.m. We right here. You see Mark at the top. Hopefully next Friday, you know, maybe he'll be back. Maybe. I guess it's his show. So we'll see. All right. Listen, everybody, be safe out here. Wear your mask. Get your vaccine. Don't get your vaccine. Don't wear your mask. Just be safe.
Back.
Just saying. All
right?
DJ Mike Caliber is
coming. Move the crowd.
Let's try it out. Listen, check me out every Friday. Let's go.
I
be really in my 90s bag on Friday. I'm saying
that you don't care where I'm at. You've given me reason to doubt you. Say you trust someone. Why you calling all around? Think I've got some dip on the side. Girl, you don't trust no one. And you're constantly in doubt. You lose the game if you play.
Let's try it out.
DJ Mike
Collins,
move the crowd.
Listen, every single Friday, just like that, 2 p.m., I'm here, out of here, right now. Peace.
See, he gone.
That's what peace means, Mark.
I'm gone. He gone.
Oh, wait. Before I'm gone, are you back on the radio tomorrow?
Wow.
We're going to talk about that next week.
Yeah, let's talk about that next week.
This week.
There is a couple of interviews happening this weekend.
We're going to talk about that. I'm going to make some graphics for this one.
You do that. Do it. You go ahead. We're going to talk about it next week.
All of this joint. All right, everybody. See y'all next week. Thank you for joining.
Yeah.